Everyone already hates Yae Miko. Now I'm not gonna go through Yae's kit, but if you are out of loop, let's just say people are disappointed and hating on Yae. It's like Kazuha's circle jerk. Something I noticed about recent trend in Genshin Impact is, they release a waifu character like Kokomi, Senhe, and soon, Yae Miko. The kits might be subpar right now, but everything will be fine after. Today we're gonna address Yae Miko, the players, and the state of Genshin Impact. I'm just gonna read some comments off Reddit and give my take on it. The first example is this. Basically a common chain of people like undecisive on whether or not to pull for Yae. They like her design, her character, personality maybe, but the kit is subpar, so they're wondering whether or not to pull for her. Now there are three types of players in Genshin Impact in my opinion. The first type is 100% waifu, they will pull for characters they like. The second type is 50% waifu, 50% meta. Yae's design and skill looks great, but actual gameplay sucks, so you're on the edge whether or not to pull. The third one is 100% gameplay only, 0% chance to pull for a character, unless it is meta. This comment chain basically discusses the second type, which is you love the character, but if the character is bad, they'll be on the fence deciding whether or not to sink their primogems on Yae. They are concerned about what happened with Kokomi basically, but I say don't worry about it. To back up my point, I'll just put this comment here from another Redditor. His points are really solid and I agree and disagree with what he says. The problem is Mihoyo can't earn money if they don't indirectly nerf mechanics. That's how gacha games operate. One character will never hold a title as the number one consensus best character in a game for a long time, or else the company developing that game will starve to death. For example, Venti was indirectly nerfed in Inazuma because nobody in Inazuma will get crowd controlled. That's why Kazuha was developed basically, so people will spend money pulling for Kazuha. The point is, if you're worried that Yae might be dead on arrival, don't be, because she will definitely see uses. Her kit might look bad and underwhelming right now in the beta, but give it time, Mihoyo would incorporate her skills to the current meta somehow. Like Kazuha, Kokomi, and Senhe eventually, Mihoyo will find a way to balance things out. What do you guys think about the Yae situation? Will Mihoyo just say, everyone is waiting to pull for Yae since summer, let's just make her kit weak, we'll get sales along with the awesome reruns coming in 2.5 anyways? Or will they make Yae a best of both worlds that cater towards all categories of players in Genshin Impact? And since it's always in beta, Mihoyo can change the numbers and make Yae strong. Right now, we're in the early stages of beta, players are testing it out, it just takes time to flesh out a character. Comment on your thoughts about Yae and I will make a follow-up video later.